"The end may have been so," I answered, "but the methods I hold to have been novel and of interest."
"Pshaw, my dear fellow! What do the public, the great unobservant public, who could hardly tell a weaver by his tooth or a compositor by his left thumb, care about the finer shades of analysis and deduction? But indeed, if you are trivial, I cannot blame you, for the days of the great cases are past. Man, or at least criminal man, has lost all enterprise and originality. As to my own little practice, it seems to be degenerating into an agency for recovering lost lead pencils and giving advice to young ladies from boarding schools. I think that I have touched bottom at last, however. This note I had this morning marks my zero point, I fancy. Read it." He tossed a crumpled letter across to me. It was dated from Montague Place upon the preceding evening, and ran thus: "Dear Mr. Holmes, I am very anxious to consult you as to whether I should or should not accept a situation which has been offered to me as governess. I shall call at 10:30 tomorrow if I do not inconvenience you. Yours faithfully, Violet Hunter." "Do you know the young lady?" I asked.
"Not I."
"It is 10:30 now."
"Yes, and I have no doubt that is her ring."
"It may turn out to be of more interest than you think. You remember that the affair of the Blue Carbuncle, which appeared to be a mere whim at first, developed into a serious investigation. It may be so in this case also."